All right, so some people asked. I've been meaning to do this for a long time, but I had some problems initially when I tried it, and then I just gave up because I always have something else to tinker with. So the much maligned and kind of hated console, the PlayStation Mini, right there. A bunch of modders have been going pretty crazy. If you go over to the website modmyclassic.com, they're usually the ones that are kind of the focal point of a lot of these mini console hacks, among other things. the last I checked, you can get one of these for $20 now. They're dirt cheap. I actually have a second one because I initially bought this when they came out. I pre-ordered it and I thought it was going to be really cool, and as we all found out, it's a massive joke, including even a few of the games on here being the PAL ROMs, and they run slower. They run at 50 hertz instead of 60, like Tekken 2. So the hacks for this have been pretty active. And originally they were using a build called Bleemcast, which Bleem was a thing for the Dreamcast. It was a disc that you could get, and you could actually throw the disc in, swap it out, and play a couple of different PlayStation games on the Dreamcast, and it made it look better, and it was really cool. I actually have one somewhere. So Bleemcast for this was the initial mod. Now it's a thing called Project Iris, Eris. And it really, number one, I think it made things easier, but number two, added some better support for different emulators, etc. So even though I'm kind of a big FPGA guy, this is more of a project, a little fun thing to do since we all have a lot of time, and I'm not spending that time shaving, as you can see. So I was having a lot of problems, and the biggest issue was originally when I did this, the guy I watched a video on YouTube, and the guy said that this is the flash drive to get. It's the one he uses. Get this one. It works really well, which is a Lexar 16 gig flash drive. So, and I still have it here, and I bought it specifically for the PlayStation Mini, and I found out that this doesn't work. The Mini doesn't like this flash drive, and that's not a an uncommon thing, even with PCs. I mean, we had that problem with the PS4 for a long time. There's drives that it doesn't like, etc., etc. So I grabbed another. I have a ton of flash drives here. I get whenever I go to like an E3 or a PAX or whatever, I just get a ton of different flash drives, and I've usually got a bunch of them sitting here on my desk. So I grabbed this one, and it works. Problem is, this is a really small flash drive, so I can't really load anything onto it. So with this, it'll install something on the internal flash memory, like on the Nintendo Mini and the Super Nintendo Mini and the Genesis Mini, but it doesn't have a lot of extra storage. So what they've done now is you actually install everything initially to a USB flash drive. You leave this in the whole time, so it's almost like connecting a hard drive to it. And so this is a PNY 64 gig that I'm using right now, and everything's going really well so far. This morning, I just added PSP and Nintendo DS, which the Nintendo DS, I'm not a big fan of the system, but figured why not. But they've got all the RetroArch stuff on here, so like 3DO, Sega Genesis, Sega 32X. I think there's even like TurboGrafx CD, and I mean there's a ton of stuff that it supports. I don't know how well or anything, and I'm not going to go that crazy with this. But I know some people were asking about it. I'm not going to show you all the details. What I'll do is when I put this up on YouTube, I'll link a couple of different YouTube videos or YouTube creators that I've really counted on. One of those being Ristalgia, and the other one Johnny Troche, Troche. Johnny especially did a really good in-depth, a little fast, but really good in-depth video on how to set things up step by step, and it went really, really well after I figured out that this flash drive wasn't going to work. So the other thing is, the reason that I was really bummed out about this PlayStation Classic originally was the fact that the controller that comes with it, it comes with two, is the original controller, which doesn't have the analogs. Now, with my messed up left hand, I need analog sticks. I can't do D-pads anymore. So I just wasn't that interested. This is actually the reason that I haven't really messed with the Genesis Mini as well. So at some point in time, it was on sale. there's a company called 8-Bit Do, and they do a lot of really cool, like, kind of retro-type controllers and whatnot. And they have a little USB Bluetooth adapter. And it's supposed to, they did a firmware update, and it's supposed to work on the Genesis Mini now, which I haven't tried yet. But I was curious, and I didn't read up on it. I was curious because I have it. I was like, I wonder if this will work on the PlayStation Mini, and sure enough, it does. So I happen to have a couple of extra DualShock 4s. So I put this into pairing mode, which a DualShock 4, to put it into pairing mode, you hold the share button and hold the PlayStation button on it, and it'll actually thump a little bit, and the light bar will flash, and it'll put it into pairing mode. You hit the little button on here, which I don't know if you can see too well, but you hit the button on there for a few seconds, puts it into pairing mode, and blam, it works. So the cool thing is, and I haven't really dove too deep into this thing yet, but so far the analog sticks on this will emulate the D-pad. So far, it's been great. I've actually been able to use this. Quite frankly, this might be something I put in the living room now, because I can load it up with PS1 games. I have had a couple of PS1 games that aren't working the greatest. I was trying to play Hot Shots Golf 2 the other day, or yesterday, and the timing was all off. I don't know if it was this playing poorly, or I have no idea, but the timing was way off, and I wasn't actually able to play too well, so there may still be some things here and there, but honestly, for $20, fuck, you're spending $20. You get two controllers with it. If you can use a D-pad, etc., it might be fine. Actually, it is, and the controllers are good. They're just like the PS1 controollers. But for $20, all you gotta do is buy a USB flash drive if you want a lot of storage, and you're good. It's just some of your time, and that's it. So I'm going to try to power this bad boy on. Like I said, I just threw like 5 PSP games on it, and I threw Mario Kart DS on it. So we'll see if I pick the correct. Here we go.
And we have audio.
Power play all the way, Xing.
Sound success. I'm interested to see how this runs. Come on. There we go. Oof.
Start your engines.
Wow.
Sony Computer Entertainment America production. Fasten your seatbelts for another Naughty Dog creation.
Yeah. Better than Way of the Warrior, I'll say that. Okay. Can everybody hear it now? Anyone? Anyone? Put this up on YouTube. I'll put some links in the post for like which USB flash drive I'm using, where to get the 8-bit Bluetooth, and also a
Welcome
good
to the
USB
Adventure
hub to
Arena.
Use.
You can travel around this.
Seems like it's running pretty well. Oh. the hell? This game well enough to know what all the weapons are. That's running really well. Yeah, that's running really well. I'm surprised that wasn't on the original Mini, was it? No. I mean, like, they didn't even license anything with Activision for the original Crash Bandicoot. Yeah, this title is just not very good.
Ooh.
Congratulations, you win a trophy.
Trophy, yo!
The more Wampa Fruit you collect, the faster.
Hey there. Oh shit. Oh, there we go.
So, for a long time, the mod's been Gleamcast, and they've now replaced it with a thing called Project Iris. So when you go into here, it's kind of sluggish. When you go into here, basically, the first thing is you can manage the games that are not just on the PlayStation Classic Mini when you buy it, but you can add additional PlayStation games. Further, then, you can install RetroArch and this emulation station, and you can throw, it's kind of like the NES and the SNES Classic with, you know, NES, Genesis, ColecoVision, TurboGrafx. There's PSP and DS mods, which the PSP one we didn't have very good luck with earlier on. But I wanted to try this DS one. You add them by way of a USB flash drive. So unlike the NES and the SNES Classic, for example, you throw everything on this USB flash drive. The problem that I originally had was this is the one that people told me to buy when they were first hacking and modding the PlayStation Classic. After a day of tinkering and not getting it to work, I tried a new one, a different flash drive right here, and this worked. So basically my problem was this wasn't working. I didn't want to recognize it for whatever reason. It happens. I remember that happening for a long time with PS4. Like, flash drives just didn't want to work. Specific ones didn't want to work. So right now I'm using a 64 gigabyte PNY, which is plenty of space. You can throw over 100 PlayStation games on there easily. Let's see if this works. I'm really curious if this is going to work. Yeah. Oh, okay. This doesn't want to work. Maybe. All right. Oh, shit. So anyway, and I'm just tinkering with this. I just started this yesterday. But people on Twitter were asking me to do a quick stream and show people like what you can do, what you can't do, what's available. This will be an interesting game to see if it works. So far, so good. My God, slobs. All right, so SNES is working. So I'll see how the game runs.
ARMS installation is complete. Good luck.
It's funny, I was a tester in this game, and I'm terrible at it now. Ah, yeah, this is running really well. Ah. One of my favorite soundtracks. The thing that interests me about this, I mean, every console out there, these mini consoles have been hacked so far, as far as I know. But because the PlayStation Classic was such a piece of crap when it came out, it
it's so cheap to get now. I mean, I bought a second one for $20, and that was months ago. And you can do a lot for $20. I mean, you just need a flash drive that has a decent amount of space and that works. It's compatible. That's all you need. You know, if you want to play some two-player stuff, you need to get a powered USB hub. And I'm using a DualShock 4 with the 8-bit do Bluetooth adapter. That's USB. But yeah, wow, this works. And oops. Try TurboGrafx. I haven't even tried all this stuff yet, as you can see. Ah, shit. Didn't want to do that. Alright, Blazing Lasers is running good, so that's a good test. Pi is going to pretty much do the same stuff, but for me it was sitting here and something to tinker with, and it works pretty well, but it's neat for me because, like, I've got my analog FPGAs for the Genesis and the SNES downstairs, and I don't have a great easy way to play PS1 games downstairs, except on my, you know, I can do backward compatibility on my PS3, but I don't keep my PlayStation games downstairs, so it's, you know, oh, I gotta walk all the way upstairs and get them? Come on. So it's neat, and I like the fact that I can use the DualShock 4 with the 8-bit do adapter. That's pretty badass in my opinion. Because the Mini was completely useless to me with the controller that comes with it. And it also really cracks me up that it didn't come with an analog since Metal Gear Solid's on there. So, alright. That's right, I can use that. I've got a map for the PlayStation button to pull out of this. Giggity. There we go. So, yeah, it's a neat little, you know, fun little aside. $20 you can get these for, I think, still. I'm sure you can find one on eBay, if nothing else. I'm sure you can find one used. Your son wants a web server. Yeah, I mean, this Project Iris really expanded a lot of the stuff that you could do early on with some of the earlier mods with the Blamecast. So you can create your own folders like this one here. You can manage the games right on here, so you can actually delete a game on here instead of having to unplug the USB drive and do everything. I dig this. But, like, I tried to launch Wipeout XL. It didn't want to work. But, let's see if this works.
But, you know, it is what it is. There's obviously going to be some incompatibilities. Hot Shots Golf 2, when you do the swing, it's a three-button press. You know, it's the gauge that goes up and down. And the timing is so bad on it, it's unplayable. But this was really easy. Once I got a flash drive that worked, very, very easy to do. And, yeah, I don't know. I mean, I'm not abdicating it, whatever. It was just something to tinker with, and it's fun. It was a lot of fun to mess with. I don't have Tenchu on here. I'm not a big fan of that game. Sorry. I don't even know if I have it, honestly. Because I was never a fan of it. I do not have an extra. That's not my style of game. Yeah. Okay, how do I start? Isn't there a turbo feature? Project's working. I'm just curious. Huh. Best Buy doesn't even carry these anymore. I got the Genesis Mini for $50. Oh, so this console is $50 on Amazon right now. Okay. I wouldn't look at Amazon, because a lot of that's going to be resellers trying to beef it up now that the mod stuff is getting so popular.
Welcome to NBA Jam! Showtime! Tonight's matchup, Hornets versus Timberwolves.
Yeah, so I haven't really curated the games on here or anything else. I just kind of threw some shit
Here's
on
the
here.
Tip. To Johnson.
Hit.
Gugliotta! Fantastic!
Oh, grapes.
Boom, shakalaka!
Ass kicker. Quang.
Tip warning!
Holy shit.
Gugliotta! Rider!
Holy fuck!
Oh, fantastic! Jammed it in!
Wow. I used to be so good at this game. Oh my god!
Excuse me! Oh! Warning! Excuse me!
Alright. So there you have it. I'll throw this on YouTube. Probably tomorrow. I gotta edit it together since I had to stop the stream and start it again. Or if I don't, hopefully this is enough. But I'll put some links in the comments and everything for it. And if you guys are interested, I mean, there might be a lot of people out there that have a PlayStation Classic Mini that they never messed with. It doesn't take that long to mod this thing, really. If you have a USB drive, even if you just have a small USB drive, you can do the mod and then worry about buying one to put more content on later. Yeah. I mean, really, the only PlayStation game they've had a problem with so far is Hot Shots Golf 2. For some reason, the timing's really bad. And Wipeout XL did not want to... I want to try Wipeout again, because, damn it, I want that game to work. Just didn't want to launch for whatever reason. But you know, it's cheap. If you already have it around, why not? You get a lot more enjoyment out of it. I don't think Wipeout XL wants to work. Yeah. Alright, well, any other games on here that anybody wants to see? Actually, I'm interested. This came with it, and I'm really interested if it will work with analog. I doubt it. Or I probably have to remap it manually somehow, but that'll be interesting. So on the PS1, you had to hit the analog button on the controller, and I don't know if it's going to map correctly. Ooh, I gotta get downstairs soon. I'm smoking a pork loin today that I'm gonna film. And I've never done a pork loin before, but I think it's gonna be pretty easy. Okay, let's seize that.
Welcome to the Real Racing Roots 99 Grand Prix.
Forgot that you can just jump to a race. All this just so I can see if the analog stick works. Ridge Racer.
Real Racing Roots 99 in Helter Skelter.
This is a fantastic game.
3, 2, 1, go!
Good question. I put both discs on here. That's cool that it recognized that. Okay. That's funny that this jumped back up to $50 on Amazon. Yeah, that's actually the one from Amazon, too. It's not a third party.
Look at all the accessories if you go to it. All the accessories people are selling now. USB hub. If you get a USB hub, they'll get a powered one. For sure. Oh, I love this song. But yeah. If it do Bluetooth, it's great. I'm using my regular DualShock 4. This is actually a Japanese DualShock 4. Sync right up. No problem at all. And to put the DualShock into carrying mode, just hold the share button and hit and hold the PlayStation button. And the light bar will flash and boom. Oh wow. I mean, I don't think the fact that you can mod it is totally a selling point. It actually, I mean, it makes it useful, in my opinion, because you can put good games on the list instead of a bunch of mediocre shit that they put on. There's a couple games, obviously, R4, but. Alright, I gotta. Now I'm gonna get a copyright tick because of that song. Alright, let's. I've never tried this on here. I just threw it on this morning. Well, I guess I go with the PC. I don't remember anything about this game. The funny thing about it is, though, like I said, people probably have this thing sitting around, you know? A lot of people pre-purchased it. And then it came out as an entirely total disappointment. That seems to be running fine. I mean, for the time it did look good, we used to play the hell out of this game. My friends and I would play this a lot. gonna have to settle for second. Not bad for not playing this game in how long. Yeah, so I mean, honestly, since I have that second one, I'll probably mod that one too and give it to a buddy of mine so he can show his son what we used to play. Road. Not a good first turn. It's too bad this doesn't have any like smoothing filters or anything like the PS3 does when you put PS1 games in there. It's not significant or anything, but it just cleans things up a little bit. Events, trying to put people around like usual. I don't feel any heat. So it's not like it's overclocked or anything, or but I'm also playing PlayStation on here, which is supposed to work. I mean, this will be fun to have downstairs in the living room if I want to get the urge to play a PlayStation game. It didn't take that much time, and I have a lot of it right now. Cool. Whoop. Ah. Wonder if I can remap the reset button to the PlayStation